Hello, this is Diane Dalton. This lesson is on how to use Windows Remote Assistance. This is a great tool that allows you to get or give computer help remotely to another computer. You only want to use this with a trusted person, especially if you're the one that's requesting help because you are giving access to your computer to another person over the internet. The person requesting the help initiates a session. The person that's going to give the help responds to that request for assistance. The communication session is fully encrypted and password protected for security reasons. The way it starts is by the requesting person hits the start button, all programs, the maintenance group, and Windows Remote Assistance. At this point you get this dialog box and you will click invite someone you trust to help you. That generates this password and you need to share that with the person you're requesting the help from. And at that point you wait for the other person to reconnect into the session. So the other person, the one who's going to give the help, will also start remote assistance on their computer using the same start button, all programs, maintenance, and Windows Remote Assistance, and click on the other option here, help someone who has invited you. At that point you enter in that password, and back on the requester screen they will get this dialog box that says, now that person is requesting assistance. Do you want to connect to their computer? And when you say yes, then you will establish a connection. Now on the computer of the person who's giving the help, who accepted this invitation, what they see is an image of the remote computer, and that's with this solid black background. It's what they see. As you can tell from the host computer, the start button and the task bar. And from the remote computer, you can see again the start button and the task bar. So you can see everything on that other computer. Now, it's always easier to see it happen live. So enough of the summary. We'll go to a live demo. Hello. I'm going to continue using Windows Remote Assistance. I'm on the computer of the computer expert, who's going to accept an invitation from someone who requested remote assistance. To start remote assistance, I go to the Start button, All Programs, Maintenance, and Windows Remote Assistance. And I'm going to accept the invitation of someone who has invited me. So I'll click on this, Help Someone Who Has Invited You. And I'm going to do Help Someone New. I can use the Easy Connect. That works if you're both on Windows 7. So I'll use Windows Easy Connect, and here I have to enter in the password that the other computer has sent me. In this case it's sitting in the same room as me, so I'm just going to type that in while reading the other screen. And these passwords are randomly generated and they are good for 6 hours or until the person who issued that invitation cancels it. So I'll say OK, I've double checked that that's the correct string, and now I am trying to connect to the remote computer. Now there are times when you might have connection problems and it's usually related to your firewall settings. You need to add remote assistance to the authorized computer programs that are allowed to go through the firewall. Okay, now what I see on the remote computer is a message that says, would you like to allow D. Dalton to connect to your computer? And I'm going to answer yes from the remote computer. This is the one requesting the assistance. And at this point now I can see the screen of the remote computer. And that computer has a black background and it's showing the documents folder. At this point now we're connected with the remote computer that needed assistance, and I am on the helping computer that is going to provide technical help. But at this point I can see everything on the other computer, but I can't do anything. So this pointer, it's a slightly larger mouse, is the one on the helping computer. And the smaller one, now that I've reached over and I'm working with the other on the computer that needs assistance, it is a slightly smaller version of the same mouse. So you can tell the difference. Now for me to actually have permission to make any changes remotely, again from the helping computer, I need to request control. And that comes up with a message, and you can actually see it now on the other computer, and this person has to say yes, this I will allow this one to respond. Now I will have ability to actually execute things on this computer. So I could open up Paint and I could start drawing something. Okay, so that is being done on the remote computer. I don't need to save that. So just as an example, I'll show you that I can change the background. I'll personalize it. Let's see, I happen to like the landscapes pictures. So there we are. We've just now changed background theme. So that shows that you can do things. You can also use chat if you need to. I'd already put in some message here, but the person, it can go either way. I'm now on the computer that needs help. I'm going to send a message. I can't find a file I created yesterday. Please help. The file name is dog pictures or something like that. All right, so that text message was sent from the computer that needed help to this one, and it in fact does show up in both, and I can click here. I can see it in this sidebar, so that's where I can see and pass messages back and forth. So now I can go in, and like a good IT person, I can go to a Windows Explorer and say, let's search for something called, I'm going to use some wild cards and search for dog. Well, by chance there isn't actually anything on that computer by that name, so we're not actually going to find anything because that computer has almost no files on it. But that's just an example of how you can use remote assistance to help somebody. Now, when are you going to need to do this? Well, if you're like me, you have a family member who keeps messing up their computer and calling you for assistance but can't, in a meaningful way, explain what they've done to it to cause the problem. So using Windows Remote Assistance would give you a chance to get your hands on and visually see what is being done and what is actually happening on that computer. So while you're here, you can actually run. You can run the command prompt. I guess I haven't run it. So I could run it on the other computer. I can do ipconfig. I can see all sorts of detail of what's going on and be able to provide help. I could also look at the control panel, where you can also see what their status is, what their computer settings are for networking. So you can do pretty much anything that you need to remotely to help somebody using Windows Remote Assistance. Now, when you're ready to end your session, you can end it from either one. I can go on the remote computer and click Stop Sharing. Now that doesn't end the session, that just makes the helping computer unable to make any changes. Now I'm still visually able to see what's happening on the remote computer, but I cannot actually do anything. So now when I try and click on the Start button, nothing happens. All right, so that's one step. Now the control is all in the hands of the helping computer, or the one that's being helped. Now to completely end it, all the other person has to do is to exit out of the remote Windows Assistant, and you can see how quickly that visual of the remote computer ends, and then I can, on my computer, I can exit out of that as well. Thank you, and I hope that helps you if you ever need to use Windows Remote Assistance.